लेमन ग्रास चिकन विद करी ब्रेड, वेलकम टू संजीव कपूर खजाना एंड दिस इज योर फ्रेंड शेफ सौरभ एंड टुडे आई हैव अ वेरी डिफरेंट रेसिपी फॉर यू. दिस इज अ वेरी इनोवेटिव, इट्स अ फ्यूजन ऑफ सम इंडियन फूड अलॉन्ग विद द साउथ ईस्ट एशियन फूड. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी डिफरेंट रेसिपी एंड इट्स कॉल्ड लेमन ग्रास चिकन विद करी ब्रेड. सो नाउ यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग वॉट दिस लेमन ग्रास चिकन विद करी ब्रेड इज. इट्स बेसिकली वील बी कुकिंग chicken curry with the lemon grass and a lot of herbs and spices into it. A very nice, very mild and very aromatic gravy. And the same curry, we will make the bread with this curry. So isn't it innovative? So let's start with this recipe. And to make this recipe, we need chicken breast, coconut milk, yogurt, butter, lemongrass stick stalks, some lime leaves, chopped garlic, mustard seeds, cumin, chopped green chilies, red chili powder, turmeric powder for the bread, refined flour, milk and some yeast, salt. Again, a very simple recipe as I always do. My entire purpose of making these dishes is to give you a very different recipe which you can make for other people and make them happy, and also to make them and keep them simple at the same time. So not much mise en place required. So we have this chicken. So what we'll do, we'll have these chicken, we'll cut them into long strips. I want this chicken to be more chunky when we eat it, so we'll spread it over the bread. So this is the long strips we have. So I'm using around 350 grams of chicken here, which I'm cutting into long strips, same shape, just cutting the breast sideways so that similar pieces come out. And then we have this supreme, so we'll just cut into two pieces. So this is our chicken which is ready. So now we have cut our chicken, it's time to prepare the curry. So very simple. We have this butter. I'm using butter here. You can use oil if you want. You can use any oil, any fat, as per your choice. So we have this butter here. So remember, we have to make bread later on. So what we'll do, we'll in the curry, we'll filter this curry and we'll make the dough of this curry itself. So it's a great idea and the bread is very tasty to eat. So we have this butter here. Now we have cumin. We have these mustard seeds. The butter is turning little brown and it's good for us because it will give us nice color, and the burnt butter has different aroma. It is more robust taste which comes out. Make sure it doesn't burn too much that it becomes black absolutely. So my butter is not black, it's roasting the spices. Now we have added cumin and mustard seeds. Now we have these peppercorns. So these all herbs, once they go into the butter, they will flavor the butter. So that's very important. Then we have these green chilies. So this is the spice which is going to give the flavor and the spiciness to the curry. Now I have this garlic. Put garlic, lots of garlic is required in this chicken curry. So we'll add this garlic and then we'll saute it along with the butter and the spices. A beautiful aroma is coming. Now the main fusion herb, which is lemongrass, which is normally used in Southeast Asia, a lot of places. So when I travel, I eat different type of curries, different type of things. So this is lemongrass, which I'm adding here. Now this lemongrass will give the flavor to the curry. So this lemongrass now inside this, the garlic is properly done. The lemongrass, as we have added, it's giving little bit flavor. When we'll boil it, it'll give more flavor. Now what we'll do, we'll add this pieces of chicken in this. I'll add some turmeric so it looks like a curry. Then we have this chili powder, salt, and now it's time to stir it. We will stir this chicken now and then we will saute it for at least 4 to 5 minutes till the chicken has taken some brownness over it. And now I have this beautiful remnant stock. I'm not going to chop it, just these stalks into small 3-4 inches pieces into this curry. Now what will happen, the main flavor of the lemongrass is in the lower part. So this lower part will give a lot of flavor to this curry. And also I have these kaffir lime or lime leaves. Beautiful aroma. So we can add into this. So now as you can see, our chicken is sauteing with the herbs and spices. Beautiful aroma. And it feels really great when you cook some really good dishes. And when these beautiful aromas come out, you feel really great about it. So the same I'm feeling right now. And I have this yogurt now. So again, something very Indian into this. Now this yogurt will give me some sourness. Stir this curry with this yogurt. And now we have to boil this yogurt till it becomes a bit dry. So what happens, it will give the sourness, it will give richness to the curry. It will give some granules which will be nice looking in the gravy. So friends, I've been cooking this curd from last 3-4 minutes. As you can see, it's boiling nicely and nice. It is dry in nature now, it's not so liquidy. Now again, curd, and we come to coconut milk here. Now this coconut milk is the main taste changer in this dish. So again, a fusion of curd and coconut milk together. This will give it nice thickness to the gravy. It will give beautiful aroma. This will give sweetness. Amazing ingredient. So in Thai cuisine, a lot of coconut milk is used. Even all these coastal areas, this is used. So this is inspiration from, I was traveling somewhere and I got to eat this lemongrass chicken in Seychelles. It was just amazing and it went very well with naan bread. So there was naan bread also in that buffet and we had this local lemongrass chicken. So from that, after eating that, this idea came to me, why not combine our naan kind of bread with this lemongrass chicken curry. So friends, this chicken curry is almost done. The chicken is cooked, the milk is boiled in along with the spices, herbs, the curd is there. So now what I'm thinking, I'm adding some sugar because again it's sour, it's spicy, it's aromatic, but a little bit of sugar is missing in this. So you can add, a lot of people don't like sugar in their food, so it's an optional thing which I'm doing here. I'm adding some sugar, so its sweetness gives the enhancement of the flavors. So we have this chicken now done. Now it's time for the main innovation in this recipe, which is curry bread. For the curry bread, what we'll do, we'll take out these chicken pieces on the side, take out in a plate along with all these lemongrass sticks, the lime leaves, coriander, everything will come out. So we'll have this curry which will be left over. So what, make sure you take out all the thick substances from this curry, because that will be problem when we are making dough of this curry. So I've taken out all the lemongrass sticks, all the chicken, and now some of this curry we can put in the gravy like this. So if we'll put all the curry, all the gravy, then it will be very very strong bread. So we'll use this half a curry in making the bread. So this is the chicken curry which is ready now. You can easily enjoy this with steamed rice or anything, but the innovation, the bread, which is going to be the best. We have this curry inside this mixing bowl. Now we have this fresh yeast. I have a fresh yeast, but if you don't have a fresh yeast, you can use the dry yeast which is there in the market. You can ferment it. I have told the process in my other videos also, how to ferment dry yeast. So this is fresh yeast inside this. I'll add some milk because in the too much of temperature the yeast can deactivate. So this milk inside this. We'll add some sugar because sugar is what builds up the yeast very fast. Now we have this flour inside this. So now we mix this curry bread dough along with the curry from the chicken. So the juices, chicken juices, the curry, the flavor, the coconut milk, everything in this, along with the yeast, some sugar and refined flour. So now as you can see, we have this soft and nice curry dough. So the chicken curry, we have for around 1.5 cups of flour, we need 1 cup of curry, some sugar, around 1/2 cup of milk to mix and make the dough very soft. 1 tablespoon of fresh yeast, or you can use 2 teaspoons of dry yeast and then ferment it. So this is the dough now ready. So what we'll do, we'll divide them into small balls. The size is again your decision what size you want to make. I'm making a naan size kind of ball here. So this is the way we can make nice balls. I'll tell you, when we are making any balls and the dough is very soft and sticky, what you do, take this dough like this, put in the flour, and then change it. And then you can make nice, beautiful balls. See, this is non-sticky. This is beautiful ball here. So we'll use 2 balls. And this is the third one. So now we have made the curry dough, and we have made 3-4 balls of these this dough. So now it's time to bake it. So what you do is, after the mixing of the dough, you can leave it for 15 to 20 minutes in a normal room temperature or warm place, so that the yeast gives out a lot of fermentation and the bread becomes very soft. So this is we have. You can cook it right away also, because we are using fresh yeast, so the fermentation would be there. So in a normal baking tray, put some butter so that the bread doesn't stick on the base. I'm making round breads. You can make your shape, whatever shape you want. You can make a long shape, you can make a naan shape, you can make a square, anything. So I'm making round breads here because I think that will look good along with the curry we have. So this bread goes on the baking tray. Beautiful round bread. Nice curry inside this dough. I'm not using a lot of refined flour to press it because the refined flour may make it more dry. So just make a ball and then put on the oven tray. We have some butter on the base. So this is taking a beautiful shape here. So we'll bake these 2 breads now. So you have to bake these breads at 200 degrees centigrade or 220 degree, what is the oven temperature you can. And you have to keep a watch on this because it doesn't have any specific time that will come out in this time. So normally it will take 7 to 10 minutes in the oven to bake at this temperature. So we'll wait for the bread to be baked, then we have this curry ready, and then we'll do the presentation of this dish. So now we have been baking our bread for at least almost 8 to 10 minutes. Let's see what's the status of the bread. Beautiful, beautiful, nice bread now done. Just put on the chopping board. What I'll do, I'll add some butter to it. Butter will give it nice glaze and soften it. And of course, the taste will enhance. So now our bread is ready. Now we have this curry which was taken out before. So I'm reheating this curry again, and then we'll do the presentation of this dish. Again, a very different presentation we'll do. So this is warm now. So we'll pick up this chicken pieces. I have this pasta plate with me. You can use any plate you want, but it has to be some depth so that gravy goes in that. These are beautiful lemongrass stalks we have. Just place them like this. Our leaf, lime leaf. So while you're having this, you can just squeeze this lemongrass stalks, and they will impart a very, very beautiful flavor in your mouth. So now this curry over it. Now what I'll do, I have this bread. So you can have it like that only, along with this curry. But because we are chefs and we are always in process of thinking something new, how to garnish the food and all. So this is what I'm thinking. I'll make a bite size of this bread. As you can see, just place them like this along in the curry. Just place them rapidly at whatever place you want. So this goes here, this leaf is here. So we have this bread pieces in this curry. What will happen? The bread will soak this curry which is there in the bowl, and when you will have a bite, it will give a nice soft and juicy inside, and the crust over the bread is very crusty and very nice. So this is our And we have this tomato here. This red element is missing. So I'll place a tomato slice. Then I have these beautiful coriander sprigs on the top of this amazing coriander sprig. As you can see, this is so beautiful, simple garnishes. The bread has, you know, given all the look to this dish. These stalks of lemongrass, you can just place them over and you can eat it. The tomato and the coriander and the leaf and the lime leaf. So this is your lemongrass chicken and the curry bread along with this lemongrass chicken. So my friends, enjoy it with anything you like.